rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome children for the class 7 standard. Today let us learn a lesson in history, Karnataka economic and social transformation. In this topic we are going to learn, let us understand about the fundamental aspects of social and economic development that took place in Karnataka after gaining independence. And here are sections of the society that have received the lion's share of resources of progress, and whereas other sections for various reasons. And now let us see in this topic what all the things comes here. Students, first let us study about the development in the social and economic field of Karnataka after independence, and also learning about the objectives and consequence of the land reforms and the contribution of the backward classes commission. So these are all things we are going to learn in this topic. Now let us begin from land reforms. Do you know, children, what is this land reform? This is not from present, this is an ancient old problem. The various measures that implemented to solve the problem, that is the land holdings, are called land reforms. To solve the problems for this land reform, so various of problems were taken place in early. The land is an essential part of man's life. So land is a very important for man's life. For what purpose? What is the main occupation of man here? His main occupation is cultivating a crop. Agriculture is the main occupation. So obviously he depend on the land for his existence. Land has not been distributed in an equal measure to all communities. Land reforms were undertaken to remove this inequality in land ownership. A land belonged to a person, but later a land belonged to a person, he is the ownership here. Later there are demands for that person. What are the demands here? As he start to cultivate the crops here, it is compulsory a person has to pay a tax here. And they are the rights only to a landowner. Yes, the rights belonging only to a landowner. Why? Because he is a main person. He decided whether I should cultivate the land or whether I can give my land for rent basis. In a sense, here are a tenant. Inequality resulted in concentration of wealth and unequal wealth distribution. Yes. After this, having the rights were implemented for a landowner, but later it is inequality. Means equal status was not given for this land here. And there are various efforts that created an egalitarian. What is this egalitarian? Believing based on the principle that all people are equal, leave equal rights here. Yes, all are equal in front of a law here. They should not be treated like a slaves here. What the rights is given, it should be given for a normal person also. In the year 1970, there were many questions arise by farmer and Dalits. And many movements were taken about this land distribution. There are movements that taken place, that is the farmers and Dalits movements about land distribution. And there were many movements took place demanding for the provision of land for the landless. So your movements is nothing but your protest. There were many protests taken place that the demand should be get satisfied. The lands were taken from, snatched from the landowner. The land reforms that were put into practice, then that resulted movements are as follows. So there are number of protests taken place, that is in 1970. This happened, children, after gaining independence. How to remember this, whether it's before independence or after independence here? You are going to remember, if it is 18, that is before independence here. This is 1970, that means after 47, independence it is, okay? Now let us see, your children, what are the land reforms that were put in practice as a result of these movements. Number one, it is called abolition of the zamindari system. So this is the first. The second, it's called reforms in the tenancy system. And next one, it's called maximum limit on land holdings. And the last, creation of economic holdings, development of cooperative farming. So these are the movements that took place. First, let us study about the abolition of the zamindari system, what it is. The restricting the hold of feudal class on land, this was the main objective of this measure. And this is one of the most important on land reform. In the year 1955, a committee was formed under the leadership. He was called as... In the year 1955, a committee was formed under the leadership of the ex-vice president of India, B.D. Jetty. So he was the president for this abolition of the zamindari system, and this committee made a certain recommendation. Recommendation is nothing but suggestions or proposals, that is to work, bring towards this land reform. There were many suggestions about this committee people, how to remove this abolition of this zamindari system. So the committee recommended that every family should be given maximum 116 acres dry land and 27 acres irrigated land. So here the committee decided that the land to be given for the farmers here, that is dry land as well as irrigated land. In the sense here where the land can be cultivated and another land where irrigation cannot be taken place here, where there is an absence of water. And when these recommendations helped the wealthy people, their recommendations implemented in 1957. So most of the people were very happy. Those who are well enough, they just moved to the irrigated land here, and a proposal was implemented in the year 1957 and later, but it did not change the existing system in decisive manner. It didn't work properly to bring this change here, because everyone wanted the irrigated land but not the dry land here. Yes, obviously the crops can be cultivated to the irrigated land here where there's a very good water facility, the crops can be cultivated. But here where the drought area land, can we cultivate the crops? No, a farmer feels very uneasy to cultivate the crops here. Mostly he tried to depend on rain for the purpose of cultivation of water. Now to the present we have so many new inventions of irrigation method, but those times where a farmer just depended on rain for cultivating crops here. Can you observe this picture, children? This is on abolition. How the people were now tortured, that is that they had to pay a the lands were taken from the landowner. Here you have a few points about this abolition of the zamindari system, children. You can just go through and detail you are going to study for the next higher classes. The land reform law that was implemented in the year 1974 that played a decisive role in changing the existing system. So here the laws under the leadership of Jati, in 1955, a committee was formed and later a two group of lands were given. Then again in 1957, again a suggestion was implied here, but later in 1974, it brought in completely change for this land reform. The next we are going to learn the movement, the protest, it's called reforms in the tenancy system. Tenancy is nothing but possession of land here. So most of the Indian tenants, they faced many problems by taking up that's a land. The problems were huge in amount, that they had to, a person who is not having a land, he works on land on the basis of rent here, that he has to pay a money in form of rent, but he know the method of cultivation. Huge amount of rent to be paid, insecure land holdings and landless farm workers. A person, those who don't have a land, so they try to take the land by paying money, that is called as a rent here, and land holding. So they had to undergo for many things after taking a land for rent here. Landless farm also, but it brought in benefit for the people, those who don't have land here. Many people started to work on the land here because they know the method of cultivation. And in order to solve all these problems here, in the year 1974, a chief minister that he brought in change to Karnataka, and he said, yes, Chief Minister D. Devraj Urus, he brought into force revolutionary law that in Karnataka that said the tiller is the owner of the land. Yes, a person who knows the cultivation, he is the owner of the land. Many landless people who had been cultivating the land under tenancy became landowners. A people, those who are paying the rent and are working as a farmer, farm workers, so they turn into as a landowner because they know the cultivation of crops and they know to till the land, so they are regarded as the owner of the land. So who said this one? This was said by Dr. D. Devraj Urus. And there are some main features in the year 1974 that's called the land reform. The Amendment Act was passed. Number one, it cancelled all kinds of tenancy. That was the first Amendment Act that was done by Devraj Urus. The tiller was given the opportunity to establish his right to the land he cultivated. Yes, a farmer, a person who knows to till the land here, he was given an opportunity and his right to cultivate the crops here. and all the lands on rent came into possessive of the government. The lands that were under the rent here that came under government, and those who wished to establish the rights of the land, those who wanted to comprehend compensation had to apply to tribunals. Yet the people, those who were paying a rent, that lands came under the government. Number two, and who wished to establish that the people, those who want the right on the land here, that they had to pay a penalty that became as in compulsory for the tiller of the land here. The decision of the tribunal was final. Yes, the first thing was what? The land came under control, those who were paying as a rent to the government here. The second, establishment of the rights to the land here. Number three, who wanted to compensation had to apply to tribunal. Who want to pay the fine penalty for that land here, they are most welcome. And that was the final judgment that was put up a question only in the High Court. That's made a benefit for the farmers here.